We sit here, right, Jerod, and talk about a guy getting suspended for a play.
Right.
You know, and we're like, what does that even accomplish? Like, I'm sitting here, and, you know, we get emotional after these games. And so, you know, I apologize in advance. It comes with the territory.
Hey, do your job. But, you know, whatever it is, do your job.
But, you know, I look at that situation with Jadeveon, for example, mm-hmm. and I say, how possibly did it get to this point? And the frustration mm-hmm. for me is that your approach to handling this stuff mm-hmm. is different than Mike Tomlin's. You know, Mike Tomlin might come out and mm-hmm. be, you know, very clear, mm-hmm. and you like to handle things in-house, and I have to respect that. But do you think you're getting to the point where you're comfortable enough in this role where you can be a little bit more transparent? Because really, when you're transparent with us, you're transparent with the fans. And I think the fans crave that in you, Coach. I think they want to get to know you better, not just sort of the brick wall that sometimes they see up on the 10 o'clock news at night, you know?
I would say this. We have very intelligent fans in Northeast Ohio, Browns fans. So, you know, I'm always trying to be fair to our players. I'll be honest, I don't like to put internal issues out there in the public. That's just not, I don't believe in that. I don't think that's fair to our players. There are things that happen behind closed doors that are always going to stay behind closed doors with me. I just think that's the right way to treat people. I respect our fans. Their passion for this in instances like that or whatever it is. Like, I understand that they want to hear every detail, but I'm trying to be fair also to the players. And The last thing I would say is it's not about me. Mm. I never, ever, ever will make this about me. And the easiest thing I can do is just be myself, and that's what I'll do.
All right, and from a player's perspective, you will appreciate the consistency in that. But I also know, too, there are some players that I dealt with as a teammate. All right, Coach just told you this privately. Apparently he needs to go publicly with it in order to get your attention, and that does occur. But at the same time, I appreciate what you're doing because I learned from Bill – I mean, he's all about team as well. And the perspective is, I'm not going to say much because I want to focus back on the team. And I don't think people quite understand the role of what you guys as coaches go through. And obviously, you had a tough decision to make last week in regards to letting Joe go. And when you see a guy busting his ass, working hard and doing the things necessary, obviously that's not an easy decision to make. But can you just give us some insight into, like, what your day is like so people could understand? Because I always make the joke that you guys work 26 hours in a 24-hour day.
Well, the pushback I'd give you there is there's a lot of people in this world that are working harder than I am. Mm-hmm. You know, we may put in the hours, but there's people that are working double shifts that are working harder than coaches.
Yeah. Thanks for saying that about me.
Not you.
I appreciate it.
Everybody else. No, you know, I think our day-to-day, what I'm trying to do is treat people right, mm-hmm. be fair. In season, obviously, you are trying to be hyper efficient with those hours because the clock does tick away and all of a sudden you got practice on Wednesday. But, you know, if you were in Berea for, you know, all day with us, I think you'd see a group that keeps their head down and works. And that's where we kind of keep the focus. We do have fun. That's one of the things that I do want our coaches, I do want our players to have enough personality to have fun on the practice field in the meeting rooms because it's a long season, and I want to make sure that the atmosphere is not one of you know, drudgery, if you will. So that's really the mentality, that's trying the environment that we're trying to promote down there at 76 Lou Groza.